our discipline of economics as a science predisposes all economists to be in favor of a market system, of a free market. Because that's our business. We come to understand how a market operates. It's a much more sensitive and sophisticated instrument than it may appear on the surface or than the ordinary man in the street believes it. So every economist has a predisposition to be in favor of a market system. On the other hand, the major growth area for jobs for economists has risen out of government regulation. So the special interest of economists is to be in favor of government regulation. How do you reconcile these? Again, don't misunderstand me. I'm not saying anybody is doing this in a Machiavellian way. I'm just describing the unobserved forces that are at work on it. Well, the way in which many economists have implicitly reconciled it is by being in favor of the free market in general and opposed to the free market in particular. This area is a special case. It needs regulation. This area is a special case. Now, the same thing happens to businessmen. Every businessman is in favor of private enterprise. Except for himself. And he isn't. Let me emphasize, in both cases, he isn't being Machiavellian. He isn't being insincere. He isn't being devious. He sincerely believes. He knows his own case. And he sincerely is persuaded that his own case is special. And that it's in the national interest to treat it differently than other cases.
But this concept of the marketplace, has it always been with us?
Yes. Oh, every society is primarily run by the marketplace. But there are many kinds of marketplaces.
And aren't you talking
the political
about a particular kind?
I'm talking, but even the particular kind, yes, there are two main kinds of marketplaces. The economic marketplace in which you buy and sell, which has much broader relevance than you might at first suppose. And the political marketplace, in which decisions are made by votes or by authority through political position, by command.
Well, I understand, but I just wondered whether this basic agreement that you referred to among economists, all of whom relate to the economic marketplace, I was about to ask, where is it written? Where is it written that the concept of the marketplace shall prevail? Isn't this a rather modern concept? And if it is, why must we tie ourselves to it as tightly as you would have us do, as tightly as you suggest all economists would have us?
Well, let's answer that in two different ways. You say, why must we tie it to us? Because the fact of the matter is that there is no alternative mechanism that has so far been devised which will enable large and complex societies to exist. Consider what seems like the most extreme exception, the Soviet Union. It's not, in the first instance, you would say that's not a market economy. And yet, the main organization of resources in the Soviet Union is accomplished through the marketplace and not through government command. And this is true in all sorts of ways. Anybody who read Heydrich Smith's fascinating book on the Russians will discover that if something goes wrong with your electricity in your house, you don't call a state office and have them send somebody. You get a government employee on his spare time to come in and fix it for you.
You know, the same thing is true here, if you can.
Of course, of course. Well, no, if you can't here, you hire somebody. But in Russia, supposedly, you ought to get a state official, a governmental official. It's all done by government agencies. It's not here yet. Go on. Take food. Something like 25, 30, 35% of the people in the Soviet Union are required to produce the food. They permit small private plots. Those plots account for 2 to 3% of the arable land of the Soviet Union. They produce a third of the food in private markets and distributed through markets. If you look at the way in which labor is organized, the buyers are governmental agencies. But people are attracted to one job or another by the pay that is offered to them. Fundamentally, the Soviet Union is a market economy, but it's a distorted market economy because the extraordinarily great role of government forces the market into channels which are not efficient and not effective, and so much of its power is wasted in simply overcoming the bureaucratic mess of the government. That's why the Soviet Union has such a low standard of life. So it's interesting that on a matter of theory, well, I don't like that word, and a matter of sort of abstract ideal, you can conceptualize a command economy in which the market plays no role. It's an army. A general gives an order to a colonel to a major to a captain, and so on down the line. Or you can visualize a voluntary exchange economy, a pure market economy in which everything is conducted by voluntary agreement among individuals, purchase and sale. But as a matter of practical experience, no complicated society can be run solely on the command principle. It's just impossible.